let's speculate for a second. Considering that this is Donald Trump, who I'm not, you know, on CNN, I can just say I think that he actively commits crimes, then loves covering them up. I don't think that he cares at all about any sort of ethical obligation to maintain documents or whatever. Why would these? Let's say that he did take documents, and among them potentially were ones indicating something having to do with January 6th or the effort to overturn the results of the election. Why would they still exist? Why would he bring them to Mar-a-Lago? Why wouldn't he throw them into the ocean? Why would they still be there to be claimed?
And that's a good question. I mean, I think because Donald Trump probably got some advice when he was leaving office that you do have some authority over what you can bring with you. And don't worry about, you know, the Presidential Records Act, the National Archives is gonna get some of your daily calendars and your schedules. But I think Donald Trump honestly believed that he had the authority to take certain things, certain items, certain gifts from the White House and bring them with him to Florida. Why he didn't get rid of it, maybe he figured, well, the plumbing system is not so sophisticated as it is at the White House, and he can't just, you know, throw stuff down Mar-a-Lago the toilet. But yeah, I mean, or maybe he just didn't realize that some of these documents, some of his personal papers were as significant to the Department of Justice as they are. And that Donald Trump may have thought, okay, I've got this call sheet or this memo of a conversation that I had with Steve Bannon or whoever it was. Okay, this is part of my, you know, final weeks in office document. I'll just throw it over here. But maybe that's something the Department of Justice can use to sort of close the circle and then bring a conspiracy charge.
Okay, well then I have at least one more question for you, because this is all incredibly fascinating. What I wonder about though is if all of what you're saying is true, the speculation, is the FBI not playing a kind of dangerous game in that, as we're gonna get into, the right wing has lost it, not just the media figures, but basically every senator, every representative, all of them are freaking out. And they're freaking out about apparently a violation of the National Archives records or whatever. Whether, even if this story turns out to be true, like what we're speculating about, it's gonna take a little bit before we have all of those details. In the meantime, the country is going to get used to the idea that the FBI did this over a violation of the National Archives records. Doesn't that possibly lock in, this is BS, this is political? Why, if you're gonna do something so unprecedented that you know is gonna dominate the news for many days, wouldn't you wanna come with the strongest version of it?
Well, and I would also argue, not only, you're right about all of that. And I think if this was just about presidential records, then people, regardless of your political persuasion, have every right to be infuriated at the FBI. And that's why I think it's incumbent on the FBI and the Department of Justice to reveal your hand now for the sake of the integrity of your institution. This is the first time a president, an ex-president, has been raided. You have an obligation, Department of Justice, to come before the American people, issue a statement, hold a news conference with Merrick Garland and the director of the FBI, have the two of them there and say, this is the evidence that we have that convinced us we needed to do this. This is serious stuff. It's not about National Archive materials. It's about criminal conspiracies. Whatever the charge is, they have an obligation to come forward to the American people now. They can't wait 3 weeks, 4 weeks for people to sift through these documents. I think the institution and the integrity of the FBI and the Department of Justice is on the line right now. You have people calling for a civil war, and they are right to be infuriated if this is just small potatoes like National Archive material. If you've got something more, which I pray there is, because otherwise the Department of Justice is in a heap of trouble, but they have an obligation for their own reputation, their own integrity, to come to the American people right now and say, this is why this is so deadly serious.
Yeah, I think everything that you just said is true. I would add, you are being reasonable, but let's also bear in mind that there are a lot of people who are not reasonable out there. So in a hypothetical world where instead of the what we're calling sort of the cover story for the FBI being what they go with, if they instead said, no, no, we have very strong evidence that he was directly trying to create violence on January 6th. We have blah, 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 all this stuff. Even if they came out with all that, it's not like Dan Bongino would be like, well, in that case, I guess it was justified. Not as every one of them would still be popping their top. But maybe some regular people who could potentially be won over right now by Fox News might be a little bit more open-minded about whether this is justified, how serious the crimes were. So who knows what developments are gonna come? I didn't think this was gonna happen as of yesterday. Although notably in the top 10 list that I recorded with Francesca Fiorentini, she did predict a raid on Trump's house. So that was yesterday, by the way. She's quite timely with her predictions. I just, I do worry that this might complicate things.
to your point about Republicans and perhaps be more level-headed, there are some, particularly members of the Republican Senate, who are sort of staying quiet right now because they know, anybody who sort of has followed the Department of Justice and knows about how these investigations work, understand that a raid, especially when you're talking about a public figure, is usually one of the last things that you do. So I think there's some expectation among the more level-headed senators and Republicans in Washington that, okay, the Department of Justice probably has a wild card we don't know about, and maybe it's only gonna be a few days before they either bring an indictment or bring something public that shows why this was justified. The people who are going out on a limb are people who are just, you know, are lunatics. Mark Levin said this is the worst attack on the Republic in modern history. Really? Worse than 9/11? Worse than Pearl Harbor? That's how crazy these people are. And the idea is, when you have lunatics like the right does, it actually diminishes some of the more level-headed discussion that is coming from the right, from people who are like, okay, but if this is just about presidential records, doesn't that seem like an overreach?
Yeah, you're right. And look, we don't even necessarily have to jump, I don't think, to Pearl Harbor or 9/11. Even if we're talking about like politicized attacks, right. January 6th, like right. It wasn't that long ago. That was clearly worse than a raid on Mar-a-Lago. It might have interrupted, you know, a wedding that he was crashing, but I think the Republic will sustain. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.